sympathizes, understand it is my song that I sing. My hope is in you, Lord. Away, all of you. You were my refuge. Away.
Good morning, everyone. It is wonderful to be back among you. I recognize so many of your faces. Some of you are new to me, but that's wonderful too. I was a student here from 94 until 2000, and then y'all sort of adopted me until I went to seminary and put me on staff for a while. So it really, really is wonderful to be here. Welcome to worship. Welcome to all of you in person and those of you joining us online. We are very glad that you are here. Welcome to any guests we have in our midst this morning as well. As many of you know, there are welcome cards in each of the pews. Please fill one of those out as we continue through the service today. University Lutheran is a reconciling in Christ community of faith. This means we are Lutherans dedicated to welcoming everyone just as you are, made in God's image and likeness. I would encourage you, if you have celebrations or anniversaries or milestones, to think about sharing them, either out loud here or on Facebook, and we will announce some of those in just a minute. We've got a couple of announcements looking ahead. The Lansing Concert Band is going to be here July 30th at 6 p.m., and it would be a wonderful thing for all of us to attend. And I think that was all of the ones that I remember. Are there any celebrations that anyone would like to share this morning? It was Lisa Whiting Dobson's birthday yesterday, and she is a member of our AV team. So happy birthday, Lisa. A little bit belated, but happy birthday for sure. Anyone else? And Aaron, anything coming in on Facebook? All right. Then we begin worship with the prelude. We come together to worship a God who loves us, a God who teaches wisdom, a God who delights in righteousness, a God who seeks loyalty and faithfulness, a God who rewards those who trust, a God who loves those who love. Our gathering song this morning is number 768 in your red hymnal, Lead Me, Guide Me. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Now the feast and celebration.
Let us pray. God of understanding and insight, you have spoken words too great for us to interpret. And when you speak, our hearts are warmed and our minds are stretched. Teach us your wisdom and show us how to live with joy and faith. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. Please join in the singing of the gospel acclamation. Our scripture readings this morning come to us from the book of Proverbs, the first and third chapters. The Proverbs of Solomon, son of David, king of Israel, for learning about wisdom and instruction, for understanding words of insight, for gaining instruction in wise dealing, righteousness, justice, and equity, to teach shrewdness to the simple, knowledge and prudence to the young. Let the wise also hear and gain in learning, and the discerning acquire skill, to understand a proverb and a figure, the words of the wise and their riddles. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Fools despise wisdom and instruction. My child, do not forget my teaching, but let your heart keep my commandments. For length of days and years of life and abundant welfare they will give you. Do not let loyalty and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart, so you will find favor and good repute in the sight of God and of people. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make straight your paths. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and turn away from evil. It will be a healing for your flesh and a refreshment for your body. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So on behalf of Bishop Satterley, Pastor Sprang, and all of the Synod staff, It is truly an honor to be here. I bring greetings and prayers from all of them to all of you. As you heard a little bit at the beginning of the service, this place was so formative in my faith journey and my following of the call to God in the ministry. It truly is a joy to be back with you. And slightly intimidating. That being said, I must admit that my preaching on the Old Testament is a bit rusty. While I, of course, look at the Old Testament reading most every week and sometimes can pull a string through to the gospel, I don't often focus on it. So my being here today with today's reading is a good one for various reasons. One, it challenges me, and maybe it challenges you, to look at things in a different way. And a reading about gaining knowledge and wisdom and insight is a good thing for all of us to hear. And third, the second half of the reading contains one of my top 10 sets of verses, but we'll get to that part in a minute. Throughout the book of Proverbs, you will read a lot about wisdom and foolishness, ways to gain wisdom and avoid foolishness, and predictions of what might happen if we don't do those things. Proverbs essentially comes right out and says what it is all about here in chapter 1. The stories contained in this book are for learning, for teaching, for gaining wisdom. In some ways, I might compare them to the parables of Jesus, who used those stories to help the disciples and the crowds figure out what he was trying to teach them. And here in the midst of some things that we can somewhat easily understand in our reading today, we hear about the fear of the Lord in the beginning of understanding, that it is actually the beginning of understanding. And I would like to linger here for just a moment. When we see or hear the word fear, generally I think most of us think that we should go run and hide, as you are all too familiar with what happened on campus earlier this year. I think that image of fear conjures in us that we should cower in terror, or that we might be rendered unable to speak or move of because what is unfolding right in front of us. Things that we fear should scare us. And they put us on edge. And they often cause a fight or flight response. And typically that is for a very good reason. But in Proverbs and throughout the Bible, that is not how exactly I or many biblical scholars look at this phrase, fear of the Lord. For me and for many biblical scholars, fear of the Lord is more of a sense of awe, a sense of reverence, a kind of deep and abiding respect. And all of that helps us to know that we are about to hear or see or experience something that is important, and that we need to pay attention. When we are able to get out of our own way and pay attention to God, we have the opportunity to learn something and then to help do our part to make the world a better place. And in turn, we can pass on that wisdom and insight and knowledge that we have gained, that respect and awe and love of God, to others. And then it all kind of snowballs in the best way possible. Now on to my favorite part of this reading. Those of you that know me well will not be surprised that I learned this part of Proverbs in a choir anthem. I did not learn it here, but it is entirely possible that it is in ULC's music library. It's one of those tunes that has been stuck in my head for 30-ish years, perhaps because of all the weird jumps and the one-measure key changes that we had to sing over and over and over again until it was locked in our heads. Or perhaps that even when I was in high school, God was trying to tell me that ministry was in the cards for me. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding, thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. It goes on and on, but you don't need me to sing the whole thing. And if we wanted to take a kernel from the book of Proverbs, for me, those two verses are it. It is the essence of the Ten Commandments. It is the heart of the greatest commandment that we get from Jesus, to love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. Really, this could be the heart of every Christian's existence, and the world actually would be a better place. Trust God. Put God front and center of all we do, and take the path God is leading us to. And that sounds simple for me to say, but all too often we don't lean on God's insight, but instead try to get our own way and do our own thing. And I don't say that with any sort of judgment. I get in my own way all the time. And I think humanity is in a constant battle of giving everything to God, all our fears and our worries and our cares, our concerns, our joys, giving it to God, sighing a big sigh of relief, and then 5 seconds later, clawing it all back. I get it. Even beyond the idea that so many of us have of trying to be self-sufficient in all aspects of our lives, it's pretty hard to trust in something we have never really fully experienced. I don't know about you, but I've never seen a burning bush. Nor have I heard a voice from the clouds, nor have I been able to put my hands in Jesus' hands or side when he appeared to the disciples in a locked room after the resurrection. We here and now are so far removed from the New Testament, let alone the Old, that all we have to cling to is our trust in God, our faith. And faith can certainly seem like a pretty fickle idea some days. And I wish I could stand before you with the wisdom and knowledge and insight of the writer of the book of Proverbs, so that I could share that with you, and you could share that with others, and so on and so forth. But my wisdom, our wisdom, can often be lacking. But here's the thing. Despite how much or how little wisdom we have or we gain, God's got enough. No matter how many skills we have now, gain later, or keep on losing, God will use whatever we do have in the time and space that we have them in. No matter how much we think we are a failure or a success for that matter, God is going to celebrate me and you for who we are and love us beyond measure or understanding. And when we are at our lowest, God is going to be right here. And when we are at our highest, God is going to be right here too. Because that is who God is. May we all trust in the God who is our everything and is indeed most certainly healing for our body and refreshment for our souls. Trust in the Lord with all our heart. Amen. Our next hymn this morning is number 513 in your red hymnals. Listen, God is calling. Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We continue with the prayers of the church, mindful that the response to each petition is receive our prayer. You may also share any prayer requests that you have in the comments section of Facebook.
Let us pray together for the church, the world, and all who are in need. God of understanding and discernment, you have given us words to live by, wisdom that surpasses all human understanding. Show us how to live with faith and love, so that all the world may know of your faithfulness and love. Be with our clergy and our lay leaders, especially our council, Pastor Gary, Reverend Len Dahlgren at Edgewood Lutheran Church in Fruitport, Michigan, Presiding Bishop Eaton, Bishop Satterley, and Synod staff, as they lead by example. Merciful God of wisdom, receive our prayer. Your entire creation is fully alive, blooming, storming, nurturing, raging, evolving, sustaining, and creating. Protect your good creation with your loving hands and teach us to tread lightly on all that you have made. Merciful God of wisdom, receive our prayer. The time is always right to learn and grow. Stir our hearts to learn more of your ways and give us a desire to open our hearts and minds to you, especially during this time of transition for ULC. Merciful God of wisdom, receive our prayer. Restore to healing and wholeness all who suffer, for those whose suffering is public and supported, and for those whose suffering is private and alone. Repair and restore all brokenness. We pray especially for Lynn McCurdy, Nancy Lindman, Guadalupe Saceda and her family, Carol Jolin, Sandra Brooks, Liana Greider, Diana Apple, Corbin Davis, Ashley Weifrich, Annalise Marks, Steve Veely, Bob Smith, Emily Veely, Connor Hagman, Bruce Reinhold, Michael Kruger, Ed Venus, Carl Bennett, and Joseph and Kim Kravitz. Merciful God of wisdom, receive our prayer. In every land and in each of us, there is fear and there is faith. Where there is fear, bring healing and peace. Where there is faith, bring a desire to share God's love with all who will listen. Merciful God of wisdom, receive our prayer. We remember the saints that have gone on before us and rejoice in the wisdom they shared with us, teaching us to be righteous and faithful. Merciful God of wisdom, receive our prayer.
For whom or what else shall we pray today? For our friend Kelly, who is recovering from major back surgery. Into your hands, O loving God, we lift all for whom we pray, confident in your grace and mercy, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Please share a sign of peace with one another. Peace be with you. As we come to our time of offering this morning, thank you all for your continued faithful giving. Ushers will be collecting our offering. However, you can still give in various ways, by direct deposit to the Michigan State University Federal Credit Union, to the donate button on the ULC website, by PayPal, or by mailing a check. More info on all of that can be found on ULC's website or by calling the church. Our outreach of the month this month is the Synod Honduras Ministry, and we watch the video now.
Friends, sometimes a song says it all. He leadeth me. By his own hand, he leadeth me. One of our beautiful sanctuaries here in Michigan, to a humble church in Honduras. The body and blood of our Lord ties us together as one in him.
I see Jesus in Honduras and the volunteers. in one of the first projects of Health for Life, a volunteer worked with teens teaching them about HIV/AIDS. One young teen, with tears in her eyes, shared how important that information was for her. Her grandfather had been diagnosed with AIDS, and because of what she learned, she was able to continue her relationship with him. Now, 15 years later, that same young woman is a volunteer with the HIV/AIDS support groups.
I see Jesus when I travel to Honduras and walk with the people affected by HIV through their pain and suffering. Partnering with our Companion Synod and bringing love and acceptance to these people is a ministry in which I am so grateful to participate.
Jesus made lives better with love. In Honduras, I saw young people at Lutheran churches because that love made a real difference. Rolando came as an orphan because he found love there. The youth groups brought that love even to the AIDS hospitals. These young people stayed, growing into leaders with whatever gifts they had. Rolando is a Lutheran pastor now.
And I see Jesus in our partnership with our brothers and sisters in Honduras through Daily, a 9-year-old girl that she had to share mangoes freshly harvested from the trees around there with me, and some toasted corn kernels, a little salty snack, and it just warmed my heart.
See the love of Jesus in our partnership with the Honduran churches through the Salud para la Vida, Health for Life program, in every aspect, but especially when the children are fed a meal by their parents, by their moms who prepared a healthy meal in a church setting. I think they're grateful, and I think they feel the love of Jesus.
Jesus in our partnership with Honduras when the barriers come down. When we can bridge the barriers between distance, language, politics, and class to heal, feed, and love each other. I see Jesus at work in that wonderful ministry, and I'm very excited to be able to be a part of it.
Hola, muy buenas tardes. Espero se encuentren bien de salud. Mi nombre es Nidia Vivas. Soy de Honduras y pertenezco al Proyecto de Salud, un proyecto maravilloso que ha venido a cubrir muchas necesidades de nuestras comunidades como ICLH. Hoy quiero expresar cómo nosotros vemos a Jesús en nuestro trabajo en conjunto. Sabemos que Michigan y Honduras tenemos un solo objetivo, y ese objetivo es servir a nuestras comunidades, es servir a aquellas personas que necesitan apoyo, sea económico, emocional o espiritual. Gracias al equipo de Michigan, nosotros hemos desarrollado la forma de cómo tratamos a las personas, en cómo servimos a cada persona. Tenemos un ejemplo muy maravilloso que nos habla en la Biblia, que Jesús vino a servir al mundo. Y nosotros, como parte de este proyecto de salud, damos el servicio de estar con aquellas personas que están enfermas, darles quizás una palabra de aliento o estar ahí en toda su recuperación. Gracias, Michigan, por estar siempre pendiente de nosotros. Gracias por hacer más fácil esta obra, esta acción que estamos haciendo en nuestras comunidades. Gracias por el apoyo económico que nos han brindado. Buenas tardes.
Gathered into one to become our bread. So may all your
Let us pray together. Abundant God, you have given us gifts that delight and bring joy. Today we give back to you a portion of the generous gifts you have given to us, a token of appreciation for your generosity and faithfulness. Receive our gifts with joy and share your abundance with all the world. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy God, our Maker, Redeemer, and Healer, in the harmonious world of your creation, in the plants and animals, the seas and stars, we're whole and well in your praise. When sin scarred the world, you sent your Son to heal our ills and to form us again into one. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his acts of healing, his body given up, and his victory over death, we await that day when all the peoples of the earth will come to the river to enjoy the tree of life. Send your Spirit upon us and this meal. As grains scattered on the hillside become one bread, so let your church be gathered from the ends of the earth, that all may be fed with the bread of life, your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your love and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. For communion this morning, our ushers will invite you to come forward down the center aisle and receive either wine or grape juice. All of our bread is now gluten-free, and you are invited then to return to your seats by the sides. If coming forward is a challenge, please let an usher know so that we can meet you where you are with communion. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, given and shed for you.
Thank you.
Please stand in body or spirit. And now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, our life, our strength, our food, we give you thanks for sustaining us with the body and blood of your Son. By your Holy Spirit, enliven us to be his body in the world, that more and more we will give you praise and serve your earth and its many peoples. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Our sending song this morning is number 821 in our red hymnals, Shout to the Lord.
Trusting the wisdom of God. Thanks be to God.